Come on, Kelly, won't she? I'm gonna tell y'all why I'm playing this song, bitch. I just got finished watching The Living You Was Wrong. Season 3, episode 13. What was the name of this damn episode, bitch? Y'all know I'm so bad at this shit. Suling Mai. And Suling Mai is the goddamn alias that they gave Pete Love Crazy Ass, so that Addy Crazy Ass won't find him and try to take him the hell up out of here, bitch. Try to take him to Jesus before his time. But let's jump right up into this episode, child. Marcie, you was one petty ass bitch, and I was all here for it. Child, when she said, bitch, you can wait outside for Brad to bring your... she said... when Alex said that she'll call her cab to take her home, and when Marcie ass said, well, then I won't see Brad, bitch, I fell the fuck out. Yes, ma'am, Marcie, you better come through and let her. Alex, let me tell you something. You pick and choose when you want to be a strong bitch, and ain't nobody got time for that shit. You understand me? At the end of the goddamn day, you got to take the responsibility for this shit. Yes, Randall was fucked up for fucking around on his wife with you and all that other good shit, and both of y'all bitches got what the fuck y'all deserve for fucking around on with each other, on y'all prospective spouses. But Alex, this whole shit was your fucking fault because you wasn't woman enough to stand up and handle your responsibilities and wear your responsibility on your shoulder like a real ass bitch. You went and ran your mouth to your family, and then all of this shit had to be all brought out the way that it did. It's your fault. You can't blame nobody else but yourself. You can't even blame Randall for that shit. Because, bitch, a bitch like me wouldn't have handled my own shit. You understand me? I wouldn't have had to have gone to my parents and expected my parents to handle my own bullshit gun. Hell no. Especially knowing that my family's some goddamn racist bitch. No, God. I'm not even about to put my life in danger as well as his life in danger. Fuck his life. The baby's life in danger. Because the baby life ain't had shit to do with that shit. Randall, I'm gonna get your crazy ass together too. Randall, you still crazy as a Bessie bug, and your mama was absolutely, and Alex was absolutely right. Your ass ain't gonna never fucking learn. And you feel like because you work with the police, because you a damn psychiatrist. Ain't it funny how all the crazy schizophrenic people are psychiatrists? Bitch, child, please. All they got to do is let your mama come up in there, and they're going to take the word of the woman that spread her egos open to push your big-headed ass out before they believe any goddamn body. And the mama done already told you to let that situation go. She really don't even want to have shit to do with that goddamn baby, and I don't motherfucker blame her at all. The whole situation is messy and petty, and that shit is gonna bite you in your goddamn ass. You too fucking smart for your own good, but bitch, you ain't that goddamn smart. You just crazy as all outdoors, and it's all gonna be brought to light while you sitting there. And Alex, I'm gonna tell you something. You got his ass together too, bitch, and I was living for it, because you was telling him you got his ass slammed together. Like, bitch, while you running around here trying to get my child taken away from you, you better go figure out where the fuck your mama at, bitch. He snapped back down into reality, because remember, he don't know that his mama is still alive. He don't know that they got to his mama in time. And he running around town looking for his mama and all that shit. Yes, God, Alex, come through. You come through when you're supposed to come through, but bitch, not really, because a real woman would have handled that whole situation in a completely different light. You didn't. And I'm not going to use the excuse that you white, because I got a lot of white bitches as friends, and they think the way I do. That shit wouldn't have went down if it was done. Oh, at least not like that. Bitch, don't you hate every time? Nobody never wants to call you or disturb you until you fucking doing something. They don't ever want to call your ass when you just sitting around not doing shit. Every time I want to get on the tube to talk to y'all, somebody always want me for something. But anyway, I got Randall crazy ass together. He was an easy read. So was Alex. Marcie, bitch, you went in and let have. Travis, you crazy as a goddamn Betsy bug, bag bug, chicken with a head cut off, all that shit. John, let me tell you something. That store you was trying to sell to Rick, his ass won't buy. Did y'all see the way he was looking at him when he was praying for that damn man, Travis? You laid it on all too goddamn thick. And had this been a real ass scenario, your head would have been the first one on the motherfucking chopping block to get chopped the fuck off, okay? That man won't buy none of that damn story you was telling him. And in fact, when you walked away, he was like, child, please, I'm going to come with some goddamn handcuffs with that crazy ass story you told him. Come through, Rick. Rick, if you ever see this video, child, you is so goddamn fine. The way you was looking at him when he was praying for you, bitch, I had to go and get me and plug him up and plug it all up in my hole, child. Because I'm telling you, a mighty rush of wind just came over me and I was finna flow like the River Jordan. Rick ass is fine. Y'all bitches can say whatever the fuck y'all want about Miss Tyler, but Miss Tyler knows where to find all the heezies at, and I'm all here for it. But yeah, Travis, you just as crazy as shit. And then you trying, and then where'd this other bitch come from? Shit, you had everybody goddamn confused. Kelly was like, child, don't nobody give a fuck that you with Calista now. And that won't even fuck a Calista, bitch. I mean, Travis, whatever the fuck you doing to these bitches, Travis, you must really be laying down some serious pipe, because you got a bunch of hoes with your crazy ass. Child, please. Kelly, this is why you need to leave the little young punks alone. See, the little young punks, see, you threw that grown-ass woman pussy on him, and he can't take it. So, yeah, you need to go ahead and leave that goddamn man alone. Something's wrong with Travis. He got a few screws loose. I don't know whether it's because he was sheltered as a child, because he was the preacher's kid. I don't know whether, you know, it was because his parents always ran his life. I don't know what the situation is. But, bitch, I'm going to pray for you. And hopefully Tyler get his ass together at the end of all of this shit, because Tyler always goes up for the women, because he is one his goddamn self, bitch, and he gonna go up and go in and la have for the women. And I'm not mad at you, Miss Tyler. No, ma'am, not mad at you at all. And don't get upset about me calling you a ma'am or none of that shit, but bitch, child, listen, I'm gay. I know a queen when I see one, honey. That's just what it is. What else? Girl, these damn dry-ass scenes with Esperanza and goddamn Kelly. I mean, just the repetitive, asking the same questions back and forth. Tyler, you really need to get yourself together with that, though, bitch. I'm so sick and tired of seeing these dry-ass scenes with the repetitive questions going back and forth. It's monotonous. And not only just between them two, between damn Steven and Eddie too, asking the same damn questions back and forth, just rewording them in a whole different light. It's redundant, Tyler. It's redundant now. Come on now. You doing a good job. Let's not ruin it. I can like you and still call you out on your shit. And while I enjoy everything that you put out, I'm just saying, them type of parts right there is what brings the show down. It slows it up. It makes it lag a little bit. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to keep lagging them scenes out, bitch. Let them all flow out. You'll capture more viewers that way and keep their damn attention. Because, child, I ain't even going to lie. Doing them type of scenes, bitch, I go to the bathroom. I go pour me some wine. I be texting motherfuckers, because my attention goes elsewhere than slow-ass scenes like that. Hint to the wise, bitch, you can take it or leave it. I mean, hey, I don't know much as you do, bitch. I'm not sitting in the other lap of luxury having millions in my goddamn pocket because I'm a playwright and a TV writer and a movie writer. I'm just speaking for the people, because I know I'm not the only one that feel that way. What else happened? We talked about Randall. We talked about Alex, Esperanza, Kelly. Didn't much really happen. We really didn't see much in Natalie. You know, she's still up in there with Joey ass. And I'm sad. Joey looked like he got into a 5-car pileup, bitch. He don't look like he got shot in his chest at all. I don't understand how a shot in the chest could fuck your face up. But, bitch, I guess. Pete. Pete is, let me see. What is his alias up here, child? His alias is, Suleiman. Pete, I'm really glad that they didn't kill your ass off like they killed Ramsey's fine ass off. Ramsey with the goddamn quickness. And I'm really glad that shit ain't happening to you, because I like your character. You bring a lot of life to the show and to the precinct. And you're a really good actor, and I appreciate what you bring. But we got to see him, bitch. He making little jokes and little comments and stuff like that, which is good. You know, Lucien feels a little bit better. He's not just sitting around there, you know, feeling all down and depressed about what happened because it was not his fault. But Lucien told him, bitch, you need to get yourself together. Don't worry about Eddie. Don't worry about Ben. I already know the tea with them two. I'm going to get their asses together. You just concentrate on getting yourself together and up and out of that damn hospital. Brad finally came through to stop Marcie from going in, letting half on Alex's ass in the goddamn house. She kissed him and every goddamn thing. He went for it. Let me tell y'all something. I think Brad always had a little something for Marcie, but because of his vows and because of the fact that he respected his wife and his family, he never took it far like them two weak-minded bitches did, Alex and Randall. And I can appreciate his character because I like Brad. I think Brad is one sexy, fine-ass foreigner child. Yes, God, he is. And I'm all here for it. If him and Marcie get together, bitch, go in, like, have y'all done already fucked, y'all may as well make it official, bitch. You might have a goddamn baby together because you sure won't fucking Randall's ass around the time you found out that you was pregnant. Your ass can't be that far along with your skinny ass. I'm not buying it. Because y'all know, just because you have a vasectomy don't mean shit. It's still possible for a man to get a woman pregnant, you know, with a vasectomy. You know, sometimes the shit just don't take. And that could be what the situation is right now, unless she be humping on Jesus. Because she sure won't giving it up to Randall. So I don't know who else she could have gotten pregnant by. What else went on, y'all? That was pretty much it. I mean, the episode, it was pretty good. Besides the little dry-ass but repetitive scenes that make the show lag, it really wasn't that bad tonight. I really can't wait till next week, though, because next week looks like it's about to be a whole bunch of shiz and IE going on, and I'm all here for it. Tyler, you're doing a really good job. I love the show. I've loved it since first season. You got my attention. I hope your ass keep it. I hope your ass see this video one day so you go on ahead and leave the little laggy scenes out and bring in all the goddamn action. But all right, y'all, I'm about to get the hell up out of here. I'm about to go see this man about this black stallion girl. Y'all know how I do. Fuck a horse. I want a black stallion, okay? So I will holler at y'all tomorrow for the Empire video as well as the Greenleaf video. I get that.